Hi, this is Jacob with PC Tech Guide, and today we're going to be talking about how to live stream a pre-recorded video for free just using the YouTube, the free version of Wirecast, and uploading it. So we'll just jump right on in. So I'm under the Video Manager, Live Events. I'm going to go ahead and enable live streaming in this account. If you haven't had live stream set up before, you have to just quickly verify your account, which I'm going to do real quick. You're going to want to agree to the terms of service. And now we can go ahead and create live event. You're going to be filling in the title, the description. There's advanced settings too that you can go through, and you know I'll let you do that on your own because it's not really needed for this. So you have your title, your description. It doesn't really matter. Right here's the key, and that is custom. So I'm going to go under custom, and I would recommend you fill all this out properly. But in my case, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to go ahead and now click on the create event. Again, custom right there. That's the real key. Now that I selected custom, I'll be able to select my bitrate. So for my video, I'm going to select 720p. I have a faster internet connection, and I know the video will play just fine there. And they do have other options that you can use. Otherwise, for the encoder, go ahead and select a Wirecast for YouTube. And right here is what you're going to be able to download it. So you have a Mac or Windows. So go ahead and download it, install it, and set it up. So now I'm in Wirecast. I'm going to go ahead and just delete this box right here, and that's me talking. Delete the shot. I'm going to go ahead and keep it over on blank. I'm going to go ahead and import my video real quick. File, import media, select the video I want, which is just a test upload, hit OK. Actually, I selected the wrong file. I selected the .cam one, so we're going to go select the right one here. Now you're going to go ahead and see I have my blank shot, and then I have my video right here. If I click on the video, it'll start playing for me. So at this point in time, I'm going to go ahead and hit the stream button. And right here, we're going to hit authenticate. And it's going to go out and it's going to authenticate my account real quick. So I just select the account I want, and then I hit the accept button. And now it's automatically going to pull in the live stream event that I have set up. You know, I set it at 720p, so all of this will be set up just fine. So we're good to go there. Now I can actually hit the stream button because now it's configured. Otherwise, you could go to output and then output settings and set up the YouTube that way too as well. So now that I hit the streaming button, and a lot of people think that if you have the streaming on, that it's actually recording right now. No, it's streaming, but it's not really recording. I have to start the recorder on YouTube's end. So I already have stream going. I'm going to go back over to YouTube here. I'm going to go to live control, and it should be able to detect now that I'm streaming. So streaming status should be good. It should come on and say, yes, you are streaming. And there it is. So it's good. So I'm going to go ahead and hit the preview button. Okay. And give it here a minute. You're going to see the start streaming button came up there, and now it's not ready to go yet because it's not dark. So we'll just wait until this is actually clickable. And it took about 10, 15 seconds there. So now when I go ahead and hit start streaming is when I'll actually start the recording process. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. I'm going to hit start streaming. Okay, yes, live event. So right now I am streaming. So I'm going to go ahead and just click this button. And this is the video that I have that I'm streaming out to YouTube. Now, I want to worry about, okay, it's this video will just keep repeating. Now, I want to worry about starting the video right away. You can wait 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, same with the end of the video. And because we're just simply going to go in, we're just going to cut the video. So we'll say that the video is now done. So I'm going to go ahead and hit the stop streaming button here. It wouldn't have really mattered. I should have hit here first, really. So stop streaming. All right, when you hit the stop streaming on YouTube, that's when Wirecast will be cut off. So the stream button can keep going there. It's not really going to matter. So I'm going to go ahead and close this down. No, don't save. And I got a warning message. Hey, not receiving anymore. That's because I shut it off. So under the videos though, it should show up and it says it's processing. So I'll just let it process real quick and it shouldn't take that long. It shouldn't take more than a minute or two because this is such a small video. Hi, this is Jacob with PC Tech Guide, and